Hi, this is John back at you. The subject of this video right now is how can I speed up the drafting and permitting process? Number one, have a good idea of what you want. Sketch it out, show me photos from the internet, or better yet, drag the photos onto your desktop and email it to me so I don't have to look through miles of web pages to find it. And so I know exactly what you're talking about. The other thing is when we get into the drafting of the preliminaries, if you can look at them and make decisions quickly and mark it up, physically mark onto the preliminary printout. You print it out, you mark it up. You can take a photo with your phone and email it to me. That's fine. But typed instructions is a nightmare for my drafting people. Marking it up and notes on the plans with arrows and whatnot, red pen, whatever, very helpful. Very much speeds things up. You don't want to make rash decisions. You don't want to rush on evaluating and making changes on the preliminaries because it's a lot of money and it's a big deal. But on the other hand, you don't want to, you know, take 5 weeks because my husband's sick or he's tired or the dog ate my homework or whatever. You want to get on to it, get it done. You want to be thinking about it, you know, a couple times every day. Just spend a few minutes contemplating what you're doing because it's a big deal. It's a lot of money. It's your house. So, but that's how you can speed it up. The other thing is we don't require a lot of money to get started. However, I recommend people to give us the money for the wastewater system right away because the engineer takes 3 weeks and we can start going and we can get the site map done because he needs a site map and a floor plan. Doesn't have to be perfect. It can change. You just need something that's, you know, from a professional drafting person, you know. And so if you really want to speed it up, we can get the site map going. You show me a sketch of where you want things located. We take your TMK map off of the county website. We get the site map done really quick. And we get a floor plan done with it, which is within reason. And then I get that with your money to the wastewater engineer. And we get rolling on that. That takes 3 weeks. So that's a big deal doing that. And I don't get started on that without getting paid for the wastewater system because I have to pay him in full up front. So that's a big time speeding up, you know, strategy for sure. Very important. The other thing is that Kona, if it's the Big Island you're building on, Kona typically is a lot faster than Hilo for processing building applications. We don't guarantee this, but it's generally true. It can save you up to 2 months. Hilo's taking forever right now. At the time of this video, which is mid-March of 2015, Hilo is taking 4 months right now to issue permits. It's because they've got hiring freezes and they're slammed with plans. The Big Island is kind of going off the map, off the Richter scale for building right now as we speak. So Kona is generally going to be a better deal. It's $300 more for us to drive there and initiate it. And it's a $100 round trip for our courier. If there's any issues from the building department that need to be addressed, the courier can pick it up, bring it to us, and then when we make the change, address the changes and submit the letter from the architect or whatever we need to do, we get the courier to take it back to Kona, drop it off in the box. They can handle that. They can't initiate the process, however, but they can handle the transporting back and forth. So I hope that's helpful. Give me a call or shoot me an email. Thank you.